welcome back. Two Duluth Wolfpack seniors have been playing lacrosse together for 8 years. Today, they made collegiate commitments that will make them opponents on the field next season.
We've competed for positions together, and then this year we'll be able to play together. We're both co-captains, and it's just great to be able to share this moment with them. And then later, I'll be playing against him, and that'll just be so special.
Duluth East's Tommy Smyth, a four-year varsity defenseman, will take his skills to Elmhurst University. Also a defenseman, John Butler, has committed to play lacrosse at North Central College. Both D3 programs are in the College Conference of Illinois and Wisconsin.
Changing gears as two Duluth Wolfpack lacrosse players signed their national letters of intent today. Tommy Smyth will play for Elmhurst University, while John Butler will suit up for North Central College. The two schools both play in the College Conference of Illinois and Wisconsin, which means the current co-captains will soon be rivals. Smyth, Butler, and the Wolfpack will return to the field in April.
Saturday marks the season opener for the Duluth Wolfpack boys lacrosse team, and this is a program that has only been around 6 years, but 2 years ago, they finished 11-4 overall in the season.
You know, it's tough to fill the shoes that we had from 2 years ago. We had a very heavy senior class, and we had a lot of strong players and good kids coming through the program, but I think it's an exciting opportunity for some kids to step up.
We're pretty quick, so I think that speed can hold us through. And with our lower numbers, because of the guys we've lost, we're pretty well conditioned, so I think we can outrun most teams.
The Wolfpack will be without six guys due to quarantine protocols from school. Their first state's competition will be against White Bear Lake, who is no easy opponent.
Really just being prepared. You know, there's just trying a lot of different systems, a lot of different names that we're throwing at the kids, and trying to prepare everybody as best we can to bring that energy right off the bat.
A lot of these guys haven't had real varsity time, so we're just all going in fresh, all going in super excited to play.
That's the right mindset. The Wolfpack home opener is set for 2 p.m. tomorrow.
Rivalries we have in the Northland is on the lacrosse field. When Duluth and Hermantown Proctor meet up, you can always expect a knockout, dragout battle on the field. But first, a rainbow over Eggerdahl Field. Gorgeous. Wolfpack taking on the Stealth. And the home team would get on the board first. Dominic Thomas from behind the net. He fires and he scores. Hermantown Proctor is hype. But Duluth would respond immediately. Tommy Smyth with a rocket into the back of the net, and we are all tied up. Moments later, check out this shot from Caleb Keenan. Good luck stopping that one. Wolfpack go up 2-1. Back the other way, Josh Bristol has an opening, and he takes advantage for the goal. However, it would be the Wolfpack who would pull away late in this one as they go on to win it 12-3. Thank you.
Rep Lacrosse, Duluth Wolfpack, looking to string together back-to-back wins in their first road game against Hermantown Proctor. Stealth strike first, Dominic Thomas with the overhand shot gives Hermantown Proctor the first lead. Wolfpack respond. Tommy Smyth with a shot straight up the middle makes it 1-1. Duluth takes their first lead as Caleb Keenan with the crossbody shot. Shortly after, from about 20 yards out, it's Joshua Bristol who ties this game back up, but Duluth gets the victory.
Welcome to senior night. Do we have all the parents down on the field? All the players ready? We want to thank you all for attending tonight. This is a really special night for our seniors. We want to send them off with some great memories of Duluth Lacrosse, both Chargers and Wolfpack, and their last senior, but not least, number 46, Captain Tommy Smyth. Tommy is escorted by his dad, Corbin, mom, Carrie, and older brother, Will. Tommy is headed to Elmhurst University in the fall to study biochemistry and play lacrosse. His favorite lacrosse memory is from his freshman year when JV went 13-0 and they had the best bench squad of the varsity teams. His favorite warm-up song is artist is Skateboard Pete. Tommy would like to thank his coaches from Chargers through high school and summer programs for making him the player he is today, and his parents for helping him to get all his tournaments and games and always being supportive. Congratulations, Tommy. Congratulations to all Wolfpack seniors. We love you guys, and we miss you all. Thank you for all the memories you've given us here and also on a great season so far. Keep it up, boys.
Joining us now, head coach of the Duluth Wolfpack boys lacrosse team. We say good morning to Scott Wishart. What's going on?
Hey, Bruce. Thanks for having me.
You've got them listed as LSMs, and I'm going to have you explain to the nice people listening who might not know exactly what that entails, but your long stick midfielders, John Butler and Tommy Smyth, both heading to play D3 college in Illinois. Tell me about them.
Yeah, I mean, they're both, they're kind of our quarterbacks, if you will, from our defensive perspective. And we've actually had Tommy Smyth has been playing a lot of close ball defense, which is just your standard defensive-orientated position. He's been on the field a lot this year, kind of heading up that defensive front. LSM essentially stands for a long stick midfielder. They are allowed to play both offense and defense, and typically they gravitate towards the defensive end of things as far as that fourth long pole on the field. Tommy's been great for us as well at kind of that close pole defensive position. He's just a great athlete, very competitive, and he's a shutdown defenseman. So we put him against some of the top leading goal scorers in the state so far this year in Hill Murray and Chicago Lakes, and I think he maybe held the two of those players to one or two goals, and those guys have maybe each of them have over 40 goals apiece, so we can rely on them as a defensive kind of those quarterbacks and shut down a lot of the defensemen.
And the thing is in lacrosse, for those maybe aren't as familiar with the game, you're only allowed a certain number.
Maskless crowd on hand at PSS tonight for some Stealth versus Wolfpack lacrosse. A few minutes in, Duluth set the tone. Lars Berg finds Gavin Slattery, top cheddar. The Wolfpack take an early lead, but Proctor Hermantown hung around for a while in this one. Britton Mellon goes low for Gianni Kalenda. A close quarters goal gets the Stealth on the board, but the Wolfpack pressure was relentless all night long. Tyler Smyth doing it all himself. It was 3-0 Duluth after one, and in the second, Tommy Smyth, a snipe from the point with the long stick. It was 6-2 at the half. The Wolfpack take down the Stealth 10-5. I'll tell you what, it was beautiful tonight over Public School Stadium. Everyone seemed very happy.
For our top plays of the week, number 3, boys lacrosse, Duluth hosting Hermantown Proctor. Pass to Tommy Smyth with the wicked wrister, and he sends it in. Duluth would get the big win over their rival.
Get up!
Nice. Lacrosse now. The Duluth boys open things up against Champlin Park. Second quarter, Wolfpack up 2-1. Gavin Slattery's pass bounces off Colby Larson and into the net. It counts as Duluth goes up 3-1. A little later, it's Tommy Smyth ahead for Larson, and he takes care of the rest. And at that point, it turned into the Colby Larson show. This time, he scores off the feed from Dane Calloway. The Wolfpack would use a strong second half to come away with the win 13-8. They will face Blaine in the section semifinals on Monday.
On a beautiful night for lacrosse, it's time for the Section 7 Boys Lacrosse Section Semifinal here at Spring Lake Park High School. And it's Blaine and Duluth doing battle for the third consecutive season in the Section Semifinals. The winner tonight to take on number 4 seed Chisago Lakes, who won in an upset earlier today, as you can see.
Couldn't get that play to work. And did you see the sellout by the Wolfpack player? Head first dive to try and get closer to that back line.
Defender Tommy Smyth.